come together today to join Brent and Tagui in marriage. And who gives the bride away today? Okay. Good. Thank you. Okay. All right. Well, we already have tears going, so this is a good thing. We come together today to celebrate the vows that Brent and Tagui will make to one another, bringing to an end two separate lives and the beginning of a single life together. And it's amazing that they had not met many times over the years. They had a lot of missed opportunities to meet. They grew up just a street or two over from one another, never had bicycle accidents together, never played on the playground together. Tagui's parents run a grocery store, a market, just a little ways from Brent's house. He rode his bicycle by it all the time, drove his car past it, never went in. He bought his M&Ms somewhere else. Should have gone to the same high school together. Tagui went to Granite. Brent went to school elsewhere, though Granite was close. But he would go to Granite in the afternoons to lift weights. And Tagui would hang out with other Polynesian kids there in school, and they never met. What's wrong with you people? It wasn't until about a year ago when Brent finally got on Match.com. And it took about 1 or 2 weeks, but Tagui was the first person that he contacted, the first profile he contacted. And that's when they found out they both worked at Primary Children's and had for 5 years one floor away from each other. Never even been in an elevator together. And they went on their first date to a really upscale restaurant. That's how you roll when you make the big bucks. They ate at the cafeteria at Primary Children's. First three times together. But today, we come together to celebrate the union of these two lives. And when we were talking about this, Tagui said, well, God just didn't intend for us to meet until now. And that's a good approach to have to it. And after all the misses, they met, they fell in love, and we come to this day. And what we're doing is a good thing, because the Bible says it's not good for a man to be alone. He is the one who came up with the idea of marriage. It is a holy institution with physical responsibilities and spiritual ramifications. And since marriage is God's idea, it is wise to understand his statements and teachings concerning marriage. And so we have gone in depth over the past several weeks with what God's Word, the Bible, has to say about marriage. And today, as we come together, Brent and Tagui are saying that to the best of their understanding and their circumstances at this point, they are willing and ready to make this commitment. We've talked about a very important verse that deals with raising children. It's Proverbs 23:26, and the father looks at his son and says, my son, give me your heart and follow after my ways. It is the responsibility of the father to carry the heart of the son, to train the son, to listen to, talk with, to know the fears, the joys, the aspirations of the son, and to carry the heart of the son in a place of safety. As we were talking about these things, I asked Brent, were you able to talk with your dad? Did he carry your heart? And Brent thought for a second. He said, yeah, I could talk to him about anything. He listened, didn't judge. He gave me advice. He was always kind. And one of Brent's biggest disappointments was the loss of his dad in 2009 and his wife not being able to meet his dad. And then we had one more near miss. Because Brent would go, you're not supposed to do that in the wedding ceremony, don't you know that? Brent would go to Granite High School in the afternoon to lift weights. They had a good gym, they had a good coach. But his dad worked there. And he said, I'd go see my dad, George. And Tagui said, George who? And he said, George Unitoa, my dad, George. And she said, I knew George Unitoa. My friends and I would visit with him all the time at school. I knew your dad. They had to get married. Because she was able to do the very thing that just meant so very much to Brent, for his wife to have known his dad. And up to this point, it is the responsibility of the father of the groom to carry his heart, to listen to his hurts, fears. Be careful with that heart. And said, my son, give me your heart and follow after my ways. But on today, something different happens. The desire is for the father to be able to take the heart of the son and entrust it to a new keeper. And that new keeper is found in Proverbs 31:11 when it says, the heart of the husband trusts in his wife, and they lack nothing of value. It's on the wedding day that the father of the groom hands to the bride that heart that he has been carrying, and she becomes the new custodian of that heart. And that's what we're doing today. If I can get to the next page. It'll go faster, I'm sorry about that. It's on this day when the husband takes the responsibility of becoming essentially the pastor of this home. Let me read to you what Ephesians 5 says, a paraphrase of it. It says, husbands, love your wives, just like Jesus loved the church. He loved the church so much that he gave himself up for her. This kind of love and self-sacrifice will make your wife holy. It will make her clean as you continually cleanse yourself and her with the word of God. As a result of his love and self-sacrifice, Jesus gains a radiant church free of spot or wrinkle, a church that is holy and blameless. And as a result of the husband's love, he will gain a wife with radiant spiritual beauty, a pure, holy, and blameless wife. In short, the husband becomes the pastor, the spiritual head of this home. And so we have some vows. Brent, will you accept the responsibility of being Tagui's spiritual leader, her pastor, her spiritual covering, recognizing that you will stand in judgment for the direction this family will take?
I do.
Tagui, will you submit to Brent as your spiritual leader, honor him as your pastor, respect him as your spiritual covering, recognizing that he is the one who will stand in judgment for the direction this home will take?
I do.
Okay. Brent, will you, to the best of your ability, love Tagui like Jesus loves the church, and as he does whatever is necessary to bring growth and blessing to the church, will you do whatever is necessary to ensure her spiritual growth and blessing?
I will.
Tagui, will you respect and honor Brent as your husband and as the one person in your life who will pay any price, suffer any hardship, to see you blessed and spiritually maturing? Brent, learning to be vulnerable and transparent of heart is one of the most difficult responsibilities for the man in a marriage. Will you now entrust your heart, as much as you understand what that means today, to Tagui, the one whom God has given you to carry your deep thoughts, your secret desires, your hidden pains, and will you further commit to continue the process of entrusting more and more of yourself to Tagui as your wife as time goes by?
I will.
Tagui, Proverbs 31:11 says, the heart of the husband trusts in his wife, and they lack nothing of value. Will you, as Brent's wife, covenant that you will listen to his hurts, carry his heart, protect his unspoken feelings as much as you understand what that means today, and will you further commit to continue the process of becoming more and more of a safe place for Brent's heart as time goes by? Brent, do you determine to live the rest of your life in faithfulness and purity towards Tagui, forsaking all others, past, present, and future, for the sake of becoming one flesh with this one person as long as both of you live?
I do.
Tagui, do you determine to live the rest of your life in faithfulness and purity toward Brent, forsaking all others, past, present, and future, for the sake of becoming one flesh with this one person as long as both of you live? Brent, do you receive Tagui's stated vows as her cherished best effort to make this a godly union and to never use them as a tool or a weapon against her?
I do.
And Tagui, do you receive Brent's stated vows as his cherished best effort to make this a godly union and to never use them as a tool or a weapon against him?
I do.
Okay. Brent and Tagui have some vows that they would like to read to each other. Who would like to go first? Who wants to cry first?
You want to go first, honey?
Brent, my love, my best friend, life partner, business partner, and soulmate. I am such a blessed woman to become your wife today. Ever since our paths crossed, my life has never been the same. Before we met, I wrote a list of characteristic traits I want in my soulmate. I prayed on it daily and was grateful and thankful that God will bless me with such a person. 2 months later, we met, and my life has never been the same. When we met, I knew I met my better half. God has blessed me with more than I could have ever asked for. Not only do you have every single trait that I had listed, but you surpassed and went beyond anything I could have ever imagined. There is not a day that goes by where I don't thank God for bringing us together. Everything happening exactly as it was supposed to. You are my everything, and I love you for everything that you are. You have made me the happiest woman. I am very blessed to have you as my own, as my husband, my best friend, and life partner. You have the biggest heart and such an amazingly beautiful soul. I love you with all my heart and cherish you with everything that I am. You are my world, my hero, my best friend, my warrior, my confidant, my dream builder, my teacher, my shoulder to cry on, the one whom I can trust with everything. You help me become a better person every day, continually helping me grow into the best version of me. I promise to always be true to you, to uplift and support you. I know that no matter what trials we encounter, that we will always find strength in one another and continue to grow side by side, walking hand in hand through our amazing journey, pursuing and accomplishing all of our goals and dreams together. You complete me, and I am forever grateful for you and honored to be your wife. I vow to always love and cherish you in every way, to be your best friend, confidant, and partner in life. I vow to always love, respect, and honor you. My love for you is unconditional, and I promise to love you with every beat of my heart.
Sorry, give me a sec. Okay. Tagui, it's hard to put into a few words the way I feel and care for you. You are the missing piece of my heart that I never realized was missing until you came into my life. Ever since you came into my life, I've had a happiness and joy that I never knew existed, and you fulfilled my life so much that I know you're the blessing that I've always prayed to God for. You make me want to become the best man I can be, and I give all that I am to you. I vow to love you forever, protect you, and be the best husband and father to our future 6 children that I can be. I vow to always make you laugh and to always be there when you need someone to turn to and to have a shoulder to lean on. You're my best friend, my soulmate, my everything. And I know I can count on you in my time of need. I love you so much, and I know if my dad was here, he would be so proud to call you his daughter-in-law. I love you, honey, with all my heart, and I know we'll be together forever, never to part, because forever in my heart is where you will always be. Nobody else can enter because you have the only key.
You know, I believe it was the Amish who, in their wedding ceremony, the bride and the groom would go into the chapel by themselves, and they would sit on the front row. And after they got seated, the town recorder would slip in the back door, and he would sit on the back seat. And they would sit in silence, nobody saying anything, until finally the groom would look at the bride and say, "Tagui, I take you to be my wife." And the bride would look at the husband and say, "Brent, I take you to be my husband." And the town recorder would get up and walk out. They would sit there for a little longer. And when they left, they were married. The words that they exchange with one another are far greater gravity than any that anyone else can exchange. And so we're honored to be able to hear that. We appreciate that. Brent, do you have a ring for Tagui?
Yeah.
All right. Take Tagui's left hand, and as you place that ring on her ring finger, repeat after me. Tagui, this ring is a symbol of the covenant I am making with you today.
Tagui, this ring is a symbol of the covenant I am making with you today.
Okay. All right. Tagui, do you have a ring for Brent? Take Brent's left hand, and as you place that on his ring finger, repeat after me. Brent, this ring is a symbol of the covenant I am making with you today.
Brent, this is a symbol of the covenant I am making with you today.
Let me pray for you guys real quick. Father, thank you so much for Brent and Tagui. Thank you for the honor to be invited to witness these vows. God, thank you that you are the one who said this is a good thing, that you speak a blessing over a marriage. And Father, we bless this marriage. We thank you for the union. We thank you for the children that will be given to this marriage in advance. God, we speak peace over this home. We speak your presence. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, by the authority vested in me, I can pronounce you husband and wife. You can... And I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Brent and Tagui Unatoa.
In the city, taste my lips out in the rain. I know it's such a pity your face is as pretty as your name. Though it hurts to leave, I'm telling you, it's meant to be, my dear. 'Cause feelings fade when time is short. Down into the wilderness, we can fool around. Tell me all the things that you like, I'll turn your world around. Heaven's cold, the water here is warmer, so come and take a dip. Running through my mind the whole time, it's a one taste and if. Each shadow shimmers slow, the sunrise is calling. Oh honey, don't be boring. We'll escape into the morning and leave our woes at home. Follow me down into the wilderness, we can fool around. Tell me all the things that you like, I'll turn your world around. Heaven's cold, the water here is warmer, so come and take a dip. Honey, let's take eternity. You've got to taste to know how sweet. Honey, let's make a memory. The water's warm, let's dip our feet. Honey, let's take eternity. We can fool around. Tell me all the things that you like, I'll turn your world upside down. Heaven's cold, the water here is warmer, so come and take a dip. Running through my mind the whole time is, oh, one taste of myth, one taste of myth.
to thank everyone for coming. It's great to see you guys. We love you guys. Thank you for supporting us.
Thank you for celebrating with us.
Yes, thank you so much. Just have fun, dance it up, and drink. Be merry.
Okay, so first off, I just want to thank everybody for coming. I know you guys have been thanked many times by these two right here, but from the bottom of my heart, I want to thank everybody in attendance for Brent and Tsugui today. It's been a heartfelt evening, full of joy, full of laughter, and a ton of memories, and we plan on continuing these memories for many, many years to come. But to get started, I want to just take a brief second here, because I don't want to take long at all, to talk about Brent Tsugui, especially my little brother here, because I know him far more. Brent is, Brent was pretty much the other half of me growing up. Brent knows the insides and outs of anything I have in respects to my body, my soul, the ways I think, the way I move, and whatnot. If anybody ever had a question about me in respects to character, what I might have in respects to fashion, ideas on decision making. Brent and I think very much alike. We would be, if you compared our brains, I pretty much think we would be nearly like twins. So, Brent, I just want you to know that I love you more than life itself, and I am so proud of you, and I'm so proud of you, Tsugui, and I'm so happy for you and to you guys to start a whole new journey together. I can't wait to see what the future holds in store for you two. I can see the magic in your eyes. I see the way you guys move. I see the way you communicate. And over these past couple of years, just moving in and out together in life, in business, with God's Spirit just guiding you all the way. And I just want you to know that I have nothing but my dearest heart for you guys. And I wish you all the best. So here's to Brent and Tsugui. I love you guys. All forever.
So, what a beautiful wedding this is. And
yeah. I got you.
For a beautiful couple, they deserve every bit of this. Thank you. If you guys don't mind, I'm going to face the bride and groom, because they make me feel comfortable. But I want to thank two very special couples today that this day would not be possible without. Elizabeth and George, wherever you guys are, the bride's parents, thank you so much for raising this beautiful, intelligent, smart, wonderful person. And Bonnie, where's Bonnie? Bonnie, thank you so much for Brent. We so appreciate it. And you and George did a wonderful job at raising Brent. And we know that George is here in spirit. We know that he would never miss this. And he had a chance to meet Tsugui already. God arranged it so that Brent, and Tsugui's father, George, already met Tsugui when we were in high school. We knew him, we interacted with him, we laughed with him. We already connected, so he approves 100% of Tsugui. He does. He's up there, he's there right now giving a thumbs up to, good job, Brent, you did wonderful. And we know that God already had that planned, so that's awesome. I first met Tsugui in seventh grade, and we completely fell in love at first sight, and we've been inseparable since. And anybody that knows Tagui knows and agrees that she has the biggest heart, and she will do anything for the ones that she loves, for her family, her friends, and now Brent, her husband. And, you know, she just gives and gives and gives. She doesn't know when to stop. And that's why she needs the best of the best. And God has completely outdone himself with Brent. I mean, who could ask for anything more than Brent? He's wonderful. Yes, yes. He's wonderful in every single way. Everything that I prayed for Tagui, this is beyond anything that I could ask for. And Brent, the first time I met you, I knew that she was in good hands. She's in good hands, and I don't worry about her because of you. So, you guys are completely meant to be. You complete each other. You balance each other out. It's the yin to the yang. And we love you. So, I'm so excited for you to start this journey of husband and wife and this journey called life. And cheers to both of you and to everybody here.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Family and friends, talofa.
Talofa.
Okay, we're gonna do that one more time. Talofa.
Talofa.
Thank you. Most of you know that Brent is Samoan. What you may not know is that he comes from a line of royalty. His grandma, my auntie Pona, was the princess, also known as the taupo. A taupo has many different responsibilities. She was a mother, a caretaker, a servant, and most of all, a leader to all of her people. Pona was so special. And excellent at her responsibilities that she was able to have a picture in the United States White House. And still in history books describing her role in our Samoan culture. One of the things that a taupo does is the traditional dance called tawalunga. The tawalunga is performed to celebrate new beginning. Brent and Tagui, I know that your grandma Pona and your dad are here embracing you in this new beginning. Today, we have my Auntie Pona's great-granddaughter, Luciana Mahe, here to perform the tawalunga. During this dance, she will see all of us screaming, dancing, and throwing money. Yeah! The money is given to our new couple here to help them as they start their journey together. And we invite all of you to come up and celebrate with us.
just like a dream to me that somehow came true. And I know tomorrow will still be the same, 'cause we've had a night of a love that won't ever change.
Smile so warm and you're your cheeks so soft. There is nothing for me but to love you. And the way you look tonight.
we just wanted to say congratulations, you two.
Brent and Tagui, I am so proud of you guys. We love you with all our hearts and just want to tell you that we want to wish you the best wishes for this up-and-coming lifelong dream of yours together. Just want to say that remember that God is our glorious reason we're all here, and that to always put Him first, and He will guide the way. He will lead you on your journey here. We love you, and always seek Him out if you have any questions. We love you.
Love you guys.
Hey Tagui, Bryce and I just wanted to say that we are so happy for you, and our lives have been greatly blessed by your guys' relationship and your influence on us. You're the most amazing mentors.
You know, we will follow you guys anywhere. You know, where you go, we will go. And I wish you the best of luck. You guys are two incredible people, and have a good, good rest of your life.
Hey Brett and Tagui, Darren and I are just so happy for you guys. Congratulations, and we just want to let you guys know that we are so proud of you too. Just the partnership that we share together and the friendship that we've created. We seriously love you guys, and we wish the best for you guys. And I know we're all going to do amazing things in life together and be on the beaches of the world together, drinking margaritas and piña colada, and just we're all going diamonds. I know that for sure. We know that for sure.
For sure. And Brent, for you, for advice for happily married, before I got married to my wife here, I interviewed a lot of successful people that had really long-term marriages. The basic concept that they said is happy wife is a happy life, though, okay? We hear that over and over, but what does that really mean, okay? It means to really have patience with her, okay? Patience with her and really listen to her, because you don't want to be on your phone or be occupied, okay? If she needs your time and attention, make sure you drop everything and have your two beaming, glazing eyes, stare at your wife in the face, and just really listen to her and pay attention, because all sometimes women want you to do is to hear you out, not to fix their problems, okay? Us men, we try to fix everything. Don't fix it, just hear it out, okay? I promise you, I've learned it after 3 years now. It'd be our 3 year, then that's the best advice I can give you, my friend. Good luck on your journey.
We love you guys.
We love you guys.
Congratulations, we're so happy for you guys and for all of Primary Children's. Hopefully we represent all of us. We're so happy. Brent, you're an amazing guy and you picked a wonderful girl. You guys are perfect together. Now you just have to have cute babies. So
yeah,
congratulations.
Congratulations. You guys look great together. This is an amazing wedding. It's so nice to be up here and be around you guys. Brent, I can give you some little bit of advice. In my house, you know, I wear the pants and that's how we do it. It's always all the time. You say it is my stuff is my stuff, her stuff is my stuff, and that's how we roll, you know.
Sure.
We put it out there, and you know, if you need any advice, call me. I'll help you out. I don't know if it's the advice you want, but I'll help you out. Thanks.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, guys.
Hey, first thing is, you gotta be patient with your wife. If she's taking a long time getting ready, just sit there and be patient and just wait it out.
No, you don't. You go pound on the door, tell her she's got 5 minutes or you're leaving her and she can walk.
You gotta be a gentleman. When she's getting in a car, you gotta open the door for her.
You can open the door from the inside as easy as you can on the outside.
Look, when you're sitting at a restaurant, you gotta pull the chair up and let her sit down.
You can kick the feet out and she can squeeze in.
Okay, look. When she's crying, you gotta bring a handkerchief and let her cry on your shoulder.
No, you just hand her a cloth and say, you're fine, stop.
If she is coming in home with the whole bag of groceries, okay, you gotta run to the door and grab that groceries and bring it in.
No, you gotta go to the bag that you want, pull out what you want, hand her back the groceries.
Look, if she loves pillows when she's going to bed, you gotta give her the pillow and the blanket, and especially remind to tuck her in so she's nice and warm and cozy at night.
No, you take the pillow you want and the covers, and then she can scoot next to you if she needs to be warm.
Okay, when you're at a restaurant, it's her favorite meal. You gotta take the piece off her before you eat. You gotta give her the meal first and let her eat.
She can eat after I'm done if there's something that she wants and I haven't already eaten it.
Okay, if you're going to a bar and you're getting a drink, you gotta ask her what she wants to drink. And then you go order her first and make sure she's taken care of before you go get your drink.
Half the time you ask her what she wants to drink, she says, I don't want anything, and then she finishes yours.
Well, a man really wants to, well, women, when they want to know where they want to go eat, you got to decide. A woman likes a man that makes decisions. So think of some restaurants that you think she wants to go to eat, and then you pick it for her.
No, you just go where you want to eat, and then she can find something on the menu. We'll be fine.
Well, that's all we have for our advice tonight. We hope it helps, good or bad.
You can call. We'll advise you any way you'd like.
Yeah. Have a good night and congratulations.
Thanks, guys.
Hold on.
Hey, you guys are awesome. We are so blessed to have you in our life. And what word of encouragement or advice can I give you? I think the main thing is, Brett, obviously you found yourself a good woman, and Tagua, you obviously found yourself a good man. I mean, that's a good thing. And you guys are really committed. I think God, the spiritual part, is a really, really important thing there. Keeping him in the middle of where you guys are going, and I've never, as far as people that are passionate about life and what they're going after, I haven't met too many people that are passionate and competitive as you guys, and we are so blessed to not only know you as friends, but to have you in our business. It's awesome. We are excited for you.
Yeah, guys, I can't even begin to tell you how much we love you and respect you and are in awe of your everything that you're doing. I mean, the relationship you have with each other is just blossoming and then full of love, and your commitment to the business and everything else in life is very obvious and outstanding. The one piece of advice I like to give to newly married couples has to do with communication. It is so, so important to have open, honest, respectful communication. When something is wrong, something is bothering you, don't swallow it. Talk about it, but talk about it in a loving, caring way. Don't get, you know, nasty and hurtful, but be open. You've got to share what's on your heart and what's bothering you and what's making you feel good. Just open, honest communication is key to a good relationship. We love you guys and just look forward to watching you blossom and grow.
Hey, Brent Tagui.
Hi, guys.
This is Greg and Carrie Omori. Man, we're just having so much fun, and we just wanted to congratulate you guys again. And
congratulations.
What an exciting event and date for you guys, because this is it. This is where you guys begin life together and until the end. And we just want to share, you know, a little bit about our experience and what we could help you guys out in any way as far as marriage goes. But we think that the number one thing I think comes first is putting each other first before anything.
Before friends, before family, you both are first in each other's life.
And you know, the next thing I would say is key is communication. You know, be open. Even if it's good or bad, you know, it's better to be open and to be honest about everything.
Respect.
Yeah, we respect each other a lot. You know, love each other a lot, and really it just comes down to growing with each other, because you know the person you're going to be in the next 5 years,
it's going to be one, not two.
Yeah, and so you guys just have to grow and communicate with each other. So we love you guys.
Congratulations. We love you guys,
and we look forward to many more years of friendship and partnership with you guys. We love you.
Okay, this is Billy and Jeremy. We just want to wish the couple a beautiful and successful life together. You know, you guys got to take care of each other, cherish each other.
Bring each other up. Always be positive, always support each other.
Yes.
That's the most important thing.
Yes, to a marriage. Love each other, you know, there's gonna be good times and bad times, but you guys gotta stick it through, and God willing, everything will go all right. Salud.
Salud. Cheers.